Hi Aquarius, Sloane Rhodes here with your love and romance reading for mid-December 2016 through mid-January 2017. I'm going to be doing a past, present, future reading during this time period, past, present, future, with the Fairy Tarot, the Romance Angels Oracle Deck, and the Tarot of Sexual Magic. So let me go ahead and get the cards drawn for you, Aquarius, and I'll go ahead and get started with your reading. I have already shuffled all the decks. Do a little bit more as I tune into the energies of Aquarius. Okay, here we go, Aquarius. Seven of Autumn. Be patient. Thank you for being patient while I shuffle. Ego. Oh gosh, who else just got this? Someone else just got this. Princess of Autumn. The Five of Winter. I'll show you the cards as I see them, Aquarius. I want to say maybe it was Sag that got the Ego card. And let me get three cards from the Romance Angels. This is for Aquarius. Love and Romance. Mid-December, January. Okay, here we go. Healing family issues. Free yourself. Right under the Ego card, so that's a good place for it to be. And getting to know each other. Okay. Show you the cards as I see them, Aquarius. Healing family issues, kind of in the past position. Free yourself right there in the center and getting to know each other into the future, which is really, really lovely. And it makes sense because here you are being patient as you do the, you know, do the work to heal around this so that when you do attract love in, even if you're already with someone, you can deepen that connection with someone from a place where you feel more healed and more whole and ready to give of yourself so you don't feel like you're giving away of yourself. All right, let me get three cards from the Tarot of Sexual Magic, Aquarius. What's Aquarius up to in the bedroom? Okay. Five of Pentacles, Ten of Wands, and the Emperor. Okay, nice. We have the Stars card as an underlying emerging energy for you. Okay, so let me take in this energy for you, Aquarius. Okay, so let's just go with straight down the line here, Aquarius. So in the past position, recent past, we have this idea that you've been kind of waiting. You know, you've been doing some work. Either you or your partner has been doing some work. And you've been healing, doing some healing around this. Sorry, my phone is off. So this is nice because in order to move ahead, you know, as I've already said, you want to feel that you're more healed and able to give of yourself where you don't feel like you're giving away from yourself. And I don't know why I keep saying that, but that just keeps coming through. We also have the Five of Pentacles here, which is a card of change, a little bit of instability. So I feel like you still are undergoing some changes here because we also have the Five of Winter under the deck. Aquarius, so I feel like there's still this kind of unstable energy around you, and which is okay because it's leading to something more stable. So there's that at play here in the past. And then in the center position, a lot going on here for you, Aquarius. We have this ego card connected to the Free Yourself card. And then we have the Ten of Wands, which is the completion of something. Feeling a little, you know, there's still passion burning in the bedroom, but it's a little burned out feeling. And I feel like for some of you who are single, it's not that you're actually maybe even being physical yet. Because with this Five of Pentacles, it's kind of about change. And then the Ten is kind of, you know, at the end of something. So I kind of feel like you've been wanting to change yourself in love for not just single, but for coupled as well. Let's just talk about that for a second, because I feel like you've been wanting to change in love. And that's why you've been taking your time and doing some healing around this, regardless of whether you're coupled or single. You know, no matter how long of a relationship you're in, there's always room for growth and expansion and evolution. And so I feel like that's kind of, for those of you who are coupled, that's what the energy you've been working with, as well as for those of you who are single, just you're not doing it with someone, you're doing it with self here. But with this ego card, right here in the center, it's coming up, I think it's come up a few times for people because it's the holidays. You know, it's very common during the holidays for, you know, old expectations and agendas and other people's expectations and agendas to get caught up in ours, and it can create kind of a mess. But because we're specifically talking about love for you, Aquarius, I want to talk about this idea of freeing yourself from the self-imposed trap, self-imposed prison that we can all do, right? Because the ego is about, you know, the text of this card says the illusion of being trapped, right? So for some of you, Aquarius, it's that you've kind of convinced yourself that you are I think because we have this healing family issues, I feel like for some of you, there's this feeling that you are indeed possibly who your parents said you were, or who someone in your past said you were, so maybe an ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend, or, you know, Joey in the fourth grade said this about you and it stuck with you your whole life kind of energy. It can play out differently for everybody. But whatever that thing is, everyone has something that kind of makes them feel trapped, especially in love. Old attachments, old behaviors, addictions, alcoholism, any kind of addiction. Any time that you are placing your level of happiness or safety and security in something outside of yourself is kind of when the ego comes in. And you're being asked very beautifully here by your guides and angels, and reminded by your guides and angels, that now is a beautiful and expansive time to begin to free yourself more and more from those chains that keep us feeling as though we are bound to someone or something in the external world. And I feel like you're coming to the ending of this. So it may, for some of you, it may have something to do with sex. Maybe you have a partnership or someone that you have sex with a lot, and it's kind of you're kind of dependent upon that. But it's feeling a little tattered. Like, it's not really giving you the passion. Yeah, it's still there because it's passion, but it's not as exciting as it used to be. Maybe because I think like you're feeling like maybe you want something more. You're wanting to free yourself from just the physical fiery aspects of lovemaking, of sex, and you're wanting something more. That's kind of how it feels to me, Aquarius. And as we go kind of into the future position, we have this Princess of Autumn. So it could be a message that comes in some way, but, and it could be a younger person involved. If you are a younger person, I hope not someone who's older necessarily, who's going after someone who's younger, although, you know, of course that happens as well. But I always see the pages as being really quite young, or the princesses. But for me, more for you, Aquarius, right now, it's about taking your time. It goes back with the Seven of Autumn. Like, you're taking your time. You're taking your time around this ego energy. You're taking your time to change this pattern, and you're needing a little push to get going, but you're not quite ready yet. There's a part of you that feels like, I just need one more book. I just need to write one more paper before I'm ready to completely let go, to completely free myself from this egoic pattern, from this illusion of being trapped, from placing too much importance on material items, from getting caught up in fear and worry, from the guilt and shame associated with maybe just having having sex for the sake of sex and enjoying that up until now. But I feel like there's a bit of it that's just a little tired for you at this point, especially if you are, even if you are coupled, there may be just a part of it where you're just continually just, you know, just connecting on the physical, and there's something about it that's just not what you want anymore. It's coming to its kind of completion. We also have underneath this Princess of Autumn, this energy of kind of wanting to do a bit more research, continuing to study, research before you charge ahead here. We also have the getting to know each other card. And I feel like for you, in a lot of ways, it's like not only are you getting to know maybe someone else before you charge ahead, but also you want to get to know yourself. You want to make sure that you are clear on who you are and what you have to offer, and understanding your value more and more. And you want some stability around that. We have this Emperor energy. Like, I really do feel like for you, Aquarius, like in the future, mid-January kind of going forward, you want to make sure that you're more settled. Like, you know what you... you know yourself, so that when you do have that love connection, you feel like you've done the research on self, you've done the work, and you know yourself, and you're ready to reveal yourself. Because it says here, as you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. Well, it's difficult to reveal yourself, Aquarius, if you haven't plumbed the depths of your own psyche and soul a little bit. You know, as you reveal yourself to self, you have more to reveal to others. And anytime that we are feeling shy about revealing ourselves, a lot of times the reason that we're feeling shy is because we haven't really done the investigation on self yet. It's perfectly normal and natural, and it's okay to do that with another. But you can, when you've done it already on self, you feel more confident when you reveal yourself, because you've already kind of tested it out on self, so to speak, and you feel pretty good with who you are here. And I feel like you know, with this Five of Winter here, it's about, as I see it for you here, Aquarius, you're really wanting to get clear on the kind of person that you are, is how it feels to me. You know, you're very bright and you're very able to kind of outthink many people, and you're very inventive and innovative in your approach in many ways. And I think oftentimes this gift of yours, you've used it to kind of in your favor in a way that other people have suffered a little bit. I don't really see this so much as you being the sufferer. I see it as others suffering a bit. And you've kind of had this feeling like, yeah, you know, I kind of won again. But I think that's part of the egoic nature, because anytime you have someone who's kind of taking that position of supremacy based on the gifts that they've been given, there's a little bit of their ego involved. It's like, you know, they're doing it to feel good. Not that it's neither bad nor good. It's just is, you know, everyone has gifts, and certain times we pull them out to utilize them, and love is a perfect place to do that for everyone, because love is what really exposes ourselves to ourselves, good and bad, so to speak. All right. So, and then we have the Retreat card here as, it's time to disconnect from the world as an underlying energy. So I think a part of you is feeling a bit fatigued here, Aquarius. There's, with all this change energy and the sense of completion here and this need for stability, all that Seven of Autumn energy, that waiting energy, being patient, freeing yourself from this ego, trying to stay steady when that egoic energy comes in, that egoic pattern comes in. However it comes in for you, it's going to be different for every Aquarius. But you'll always kind of recognize it. It always has a level of fear and anxiety in there, a little bit of adrenaline running through your body, either because of the thrill of the chase or the excitement at getting something that you want out there in the external world. So that adrenaline is often a sign of ego. And it's not good or bad, it just is. But the problem that happens is that when we become associated with the ego more than the heart, then we can really get ourselves into some situations that take a little longer to get out of. So I feel like you're kind of fatigued a little bit during this time period, and there's this sense of wanting to retreat, either you with your partner, spend a little time in quiet, on a quiet vacation or trip, or just the two of you being quiet with one another, or if you're single, just you kind of retreating from the world, retreating from everything during the holiday season, allowing yourself to just be as you are and not worrying about whether or not love is going to come in the new year. You know, a lot of times we get fired up because we think, oh, the new year is coming. This year is going to be different. This year I'm going to be doing this, and this year I'm going to be doing that. And suddenly, you know, we've kind of already, our ego's getting in telling us that if we don't have it this year, this new year coming in, then we have, you know, we're really in trouble. So just make sure that you kind of identify the ego when it comes in and say, okay, thank you. I recognize you, ego, but I'm coming to the heart more. And you remind yourself that everything starts within. And you can say to yourself, if it resonates with your Aquarius, you can say, you know, I love you, Aquarius. I love and support you. I love and honor you. I love you unconditionally. I accept you unconditionally. I am the source of your happiness. I'm the first lover of you. Whatever words kind of resonate with you. And what that does, Aquarius, is it takes you out of your mind, which is a tool that you use very effectively in particular, and it brings you back to your heart, which is who you are. And when you come from your heart, then you become more open, and you remind yourself continuously that, you know, your heart is who you are, and that your mind and your ego is something that you're using to get things and do things. So I hope that makes sense for you. I do want to talk about this as well. We have the beautiful stars card as an underlying energy. So with this retreat energy, and even with this five of winter, there's a tremendous sense of rebirth is how I kind of feel like it. Like with this, the instability of this energy, this five of winter, coupled with the need for retreat, for reflection, for quietude, with that comes up this sort of rebirth of your true nature, your true Aquarian nature, this imaginative, inventive soul who can imagine the love, the highest levels of love coming in for you. And holding on to that hope and optimism will be really beneficial for you during this time period, Aquarius, just because that ego can feel very grounded and very kind of icky and sticky energy. So more of that, spending time in the imaginative realms of joy and happiness, and imagining how good it's going to feel when you have the love that you want. That can help kind of expand some of that egoic patterning that's at play here. Okay, so I want to get another card for you from the Mermaids and Dolphins, and then I'm going to close out your reading, Aquarius. And I'm choosing this deck for you because it is about play, and play is so really opens us up and takes us out of our ego, because when we're playing, just for the sheer joy of playing, we're not really worried about anything else. Consultant expert. Oh, information. That's really interesting because we have it with the Princess of Autumn, which is about, you know, wanting to study more, do more research. And it says more information is needed. Consult someone with expertise in this area. So for some of you, that will resonate very strongly, and you know exactly what this means. It may be having to do with this ego, especially if it's referring to addictions or codependent relationships. You may want to get some counseling or seek some retreat. You know, here we go. For those of you who do have an issue with addictions, but for others of you, I kind of feel like it also is about consultant expert in the field of play is how it also feels to me. Like, you know, if you can't really remember how to play because you've been so bogged down with, you know, the seven of autumn and the free yourself and the ego and all of that, for me, it means expand your horizons a little bit is how I kind of feel like it. Like, it's not about just trusting your own intuition. It's about also, you know, consulting, you know, taking a survey, so to speak, and getting more information and consulting an expert, of course, if that resonates with you. But for me, even more expansively, it's about exploring your options. So, okay, Aquarius, I hope you find that helpful and that you enjoyed your video. I wish you much love and happy holidays, and I will see you on the next video or at your private reading. Till then.